So, to go up to the statue, take a hard right, right over here. Careful not to be too loud, otherwise you'll wake up the dragon right on the other side. He's not too far. Eventually we'll have to talk to Dagon using this. Then we'll be able to enter here, because... Let's just say he's gonna summon two enemies, and those enemies will have... One of those enemies, at the very least, will have a key to enter his shrine. Also a neat statue. Dagon was really kinda ugly in Oblivion. Just as everything else was. Oblivion's not a... It's a game that doesn't age particularly well, despite the... Like, it was an early HD game, alright? It was an early HD game, that's why Oblivion feels really ugly. Even the developers poked fun at it through Maik. Anyways, there's three bandits over here. Gonna take care of them, and then we're gonna go to Morthal. Wow, how did I miss twice? I guess they're too far away. Great, now they see me. No, they're just outlaws. At least he's just an outlaw. I'm gonna reload though, because I call shenanigans on that. I should have hit them with my arrows. Okay, got rid of one of them. Now I gotta run away because those two have arrows. Not before summoning... Familiar to distract them. Also level up? Okay, cool. I need more magic. You know what? Let's do this. This way, it'll be significantly cheaper for me to continuously summon my familiars. But not the Flame Atronach. They can still see me, I don't know why I'm hiding. Okay, what are you doing, my little wolf? Okay, here we go. That's just an outlaw, so that won't be too troublesome. Wow, yeah, I don't know why I keep accidentally hitting my own familiar. Cool, got rid of you. Oh, over there, okay. Yeah, that was just a normal bandit. Oh, okay. So yeah, I'm gonna start using conjuration tricks from now on because if I make my spells really, really cheap, I can keep summoning something to distract the enemies, and while they're distracted, I can attack them from behind safely, and as soon as my summon dies, I can summon another one and they'll get distracted again, and so on and so forth until they're dead. However, it is not very effective against enemies that can easily defeat summons, or even worse, take control of them. So I best not rely on this too much. I really want to get apprentice level conjuration, so that way I'll be able to continuously cast Flame Atronach. Those will be excellent. So this is the Lord Stone. Reduces damage. It's not all that helpful because of how much damage everything is causing me in this level of difficulty, so we're gonna ignore it. Let's go to Morthal. I've delayed things enough. So, Stone Hills is right over here. Not much we can do here. There's a mine with Iron in it, I believe. Yeah, it's iron. Oh wow, I can just take these ingots? Jeez. Well, whatever. There's a little side quest you can do here if you talk to an NPC. He'll mention how You need to mention to Browling that they're having trouble. Do you own the mine?
No, and before you ask, it's not for sale. Well, no. But that's not the point. Browling owns the mine, and she's not selling. We make her some decent coin running this place. Keeps her living well in solitude. At least when we can get shipments to her. We're late on the last one. I expect her to start breathing fire any moment now. You could take word to her that there'll be a shipment soon. Buy us some time. In exchange, I'm willing to let a few ingots go missing. Maybe more than a few. You're doing me quite a favor. I'm sure she'll be angry. Brace yourself.
She won't be angry, actually. Browling's really nice, for the most part. A voice of reason, in fact. She compared to the other things of Solitude. Although I guess Falk is the nice one. Anyway, yeah, iron ingots are really useful, so guaranteeing that I will always be able to just pick them up from that place is a fine deal. Even though I could already take them. Okay, I thought that was a saber cat. Hi.
All right. Hand over your valuables.
Do I look like I have any money?
Yes, actually.
I think in unmodded Skyrim, without the unofficial patches, you cannot persuade or intimidate these thieves. I don't have time for this. Don't you walk away. He's actually pretty tough. come on. I hate when I get stuck in things like this. Trying to get up here, it's not working. Riding up diagonals. Whatever. First let's heal. Then let's summon. Still gonna be using this so often, I better put it in my favorite. Already dead, seriously. But yeah, it's very easy to take care of business when you can just do stuff like this. Yeah, and should probably use my shouts more often. Wait, what the hell? Guess my freaking summon was just a coward. There, finally distracted him. Oh, I saw that. He did a kill move on the dog. That's kind of funny. Okay, you know what? I can just take care of him like this. Because they're dumb. Die. Yes, satisfying. This is what I do to thieves. Ugh. Thieves always have at least one gem on them, so it's kind of a good thing to kill them, if you ask me. You can also catch them off guard if you sneak around and spot them before they spot you. But yeah, careful while walking around here. I do believe there's a saber cat that likes to hang around this place. Usually it's on the main road, but sometimes it's on the side. Where you won't notice it until it's too late. Oh wow, that's a spider, not a saber cat. Got 38 arrows. Where's the spider? Did it detect me? Yes, it did. Oh, wow. it killed my wolf in a single hit. That's dangerous. Wait, there's another enemy? Oh, yeah, there's some skeletons near that barrow. The skeleton is no trouble whatsoever, however. One of the easiest enemies. Not to mention I have Dawnbreaker now. Wow. The stun effect of the perk stun effect is really good for the arrows. It basically locks enemies into place. There we go. Yeah, and see, compare that to the skeleton, which only takes me two shots of, two arrows to defeat. Even though it doesn't make any sense. Is there another skeleton? No, I think that was the only one. So yeah, you Morthal, you just go down here. Seems they're having a serious discussion. Right over here.
What's the Jarl going to do about it? How are we supposed to feel safe in our own homes?
Please, enough already. I have told Ygritte of your concerns. Look after you all. Please, go about your business.
We've no need for wizards in our midst. Morthal has enough problems as it is. Ah, it's no use. Let's get back.
For those wondering, they're talking about a wizard that moved into Morthal. He's actually a master conjurist, or whatever the word is. So if you want to learn to be taught conjuration, you should talk to him. Anyway, you.
Unless it's about... Don't know what you're talking about, Strange. I've heard of him. My father had suspicions about his connection to the Mythic Dawn. Guess they were true. I don't need this. My
family. You won't miss it, then.
I don't care. My
yeah, whatever.
The vines know the mill could use some new blades. All right, it's yours. Here's the keys. It's locked in the chest inside.
I really wish I would have just persuaded him, but. My character doesn't actually have that good of a speech skill. Is there a Nurnroot over there? Yes. It's a little harder to notice in the special edition. Not sure if that's how it always was, though.
Staying safe, I hope.
Keep your wits about you.
Thonair.
Hardly a safe place.
He looks normal right now, but no, he's anything but normal. You know, it's in this chest right here. Want that, and we can also take this if we want. 53 gold. Or even dwarven armor. I'm gonna leave it alone, however. And I need to find an alchemy station. Oh, also I can brawl with this guy, Benor. I guess I'll do it, but it's gonna be annoying because this is a legendary difficulty.
Me to prove it? I bet 100 just your own two hands. Weapons and magic are out. Now let's see what you've got.
Come let's on. Go.
Let's see what you're made of.
God, this is gonna take forever. There we go. Jeez. That took a while.
That was a punch.
Huh. A punch? Come on, there was like 400 fists in there. I so wish I was the one punch man, though. Seriously, was that like 5 minutes? It was way too long, that's for sure. Well, that's why there's this enchanted item called the Gloves of the Pugilist. You can find them in Riften in the sewers, let's say. And thanks to that, these brawls were probably much more tolerable. But until I get that, these brawls are always going to be like this long. Anyway.
Oh, do come in. I hope I have what you need.
Yep, because I want this. Invisibility. Yes. Oh. Regenerate health? Okay, well that's useful. Anything else I can do?
I like your
shape. Well, I can do this. Let's find out about all of these things.
Fall every now and then. Oh, I quite like living in the hall.
I need to keep fire salts, unfortunately. Wait, wrist wrappings. Don't those have invisibility too? No. What a waste.
Mine to govern someday.
No, despite that, I think I'm doing fine. To learn.
Yes, I'm sure that's true.
So anyway, I've got the piece of Dagon's dagger from this place. Now I've got to go all the way to here, Deadcrone Rock. It's actually a pretty big dungeon, so that's going to be troublesome. There's also Cracked Tusk Keep. That's going to be my last stop. And that one's not nearly as long, fortunately. But right now, I've got to go all the way to here. Deadcrone Rock. The hell? More spiders? God damn it. Too slow. There's a dragon up here, but I'm not gonna be killing it. Hopefully it'll ignore me. Mostly I'm going through here because it's a nice shortcut when you're not fast traveling everywhere. But yeah, y'all see that dragon? It can notice you very easily. So do be careful. Mostly though, it'll start attacking a troll on the side of the mountain. I think that's neat though, that like creatures that normally attack only you can actually attack between each other. Also there's a, there is a frost troll, never mind. Yeah, are you sure it's safe here?
Hunting and fishing in these parts for years.
There's a dragon right above your head. However, we want to go into here-ish. Just a little bit higher. Please don't notice me. Dragons have a very easy time detecting your character. Anyway, if you want to fight a dragon, you go here. If you want to go into the mountain, you go here. There's definitely a troll in here. Recall. Right over there. Yeah, trolls have, they can regenerate HP, but if you burn them, they will not regenerate, I believe. So, trolls are kind of easy to deal with, if you know their attacks. Not to mention they like wasting time. But they do hit hard. But yeah, as long as you burn the trolls, you'll be fine. Kind of wish my familiar was distracting the troll right now, but I'll be fine doing this. Also, y'all notice how many enchantments Dawnbreaker has? Quite a few, huh? I'm dead. I thought this passage continued right there, but I guess not. Come on, just a little bit more. If you deal enough damage to a frost troll, they actually slump over and you can get a lot of free hits on them. Don't know why he's not approaching me right now. Guess that's just Skyrim AI for y'all. Come on. Slump over already. Just a little bit more. There we go. Yay. That took a while. Well, not that long, actually. But you need to keep attacking them, otherwise they'll fully regenerate all of their HP. That's an interesting gimmick to these trolls, actually. The fact that you have to continuously attack them if you want to actually defeat them. Their regeneration is significantly faster in Requiem, but they don't take nearly as long to defeat because of how everything deals more damage in that mod. Don't want to take the sword, but I want that other potion. Even though minor healing just doesn't help me all that much in my current difficulty. Well, I have a long trip before I finally reach a dead Crone Rock, so now what? We're gonna make a quick stop in this dungeon right down here. The dragon did not detect me, did they? Okay. I don't want to fight the dragon. I want to fight... you. Come on. Oh my goodness, the dragon did detect me. Well, I'm definitely going into that place down there then. Run bigs fast. I don't know why the skeleton is taking so much punishment, but whatever. Oh my goodness, come on. Get me out of here. Ugh. Like, I could probably take on the dragon, just it would take way too long, and I don't have enough arrows to deal with them right now. So yeah, we're doing this dungeon. I guess the enemy is still detecting because of how I'm nearby, sort of, kinda. Well, no, now they can no longer detect me. But the dragon will definitely be waiting for me as soon as I get out. Unless I use the other exit. Anyway. First things first. We got a ghost right here. Want to pickpocket him. That makes a lot of sense, right? That barely trained me. Now I want to slit his throat.
Sorry. This isn't what I want.
That was weird. It's not what you want for me to slit your throat? Also, he still had gold left. That's weird. Plentiful healing and filter of alteration. What does it do? Filter of alteration. Okay, they last 75% longer. Wish it would just make them cheaper. Okay, there's another one right over here. And I do believe there's one somewhere up there. So they might notice you without you noticing them. dumb ghost. I'm dumber. Think I can reach from here? No, not quite. However, this one's stronger. Guess I really should use Dawnbreaker against these enemies. Actually, from what we've seen, Dawnbreaker only apparently... like, it burns all enemies. However, if it destroys an undead enemy, it might cause an effect that will affect all other undead.
I'm sorry. This isn't what I want. I don't have any...
I don't even know where I'm going right now. There we go. Jeez. Because if he does a power attack on me while I'm damaged, he might actually defeat me. So that's what I was concerned about right there. That's why I kept running away. So, can I see this treasure right over there? It's an obvious trap. It's a really, really obvious trap. Also, yeah, y'all heard that. Sild the Warlock. He's down there. He's expecting us to fall for this trap. Right there. Yeah, right there. Y'all see that? I activated it. Or my familiar activated it. You fall down there, you're gonna be stuck in a cage. But it's very easy to get out. However, even though it's easy to get out, you immediately have to fight Sild the Warlock if you do that. And I don't want to do that. I want to take Sild the Warlock by surprise. I want to catch him by surprise. So we'll go through the entire dungeon in the meantime. Okay. That was actually pretty good. Yeah, you know what? Let's use Raise the Zombie. This one. Cool, it worked. For 60 seconds, this Draugr is gonna be my ally. Place blocked, but we can go up here and we'll activate the lever and that will open up that door. It's actually just one of the few instances where the lever is not right next to the door itself. Although I suppose if you want to be technical, it's right above it. How long? 19 more seconds, god damn it. So no opponent right over here? Yes, okay, okay. And because of that, my conjuration was boosted to level 21.
I don't have any choice. I'm sorry.
Unfortunately, my Draugr... Oh, wow, he does disintegrate. Huh. That's a shame. That subjugated ghost doesn't seem to be as tough as the one I face down here, but can never be too careful. Oh! God damn it. That wasn't what I wanted right there either. Coming down? Oh cool, another one. Yeah, only when your zombie is has gone up that your conjuration will be beefed up. And you see how much experience it gives me? If you really want to train your conjuration skill, you need to start raising bodies. Hi, I'm right over here.
Stay away. I don't want to do this.
Stop attacking me, please. Yeah, he's not very tough still. I always get nervous. When it's a two-handed frickin' ghost. your turn to die. Cool. So yeah, this lever is in case you, like, if you fall for the trap, you'll need to use this lever to open this gate. Now there's only one more ghost left, as well as Syl the Warlock, who's right there. Didn't expect him, but that's fine, that's fine. I want to take this and this from him. Cool, cool, cool. Train my pickpocket. Stupid freaking wolf. Yep, nobody here now.
I know you're up there.
Yes. Stone flesh. Can I use stone flesh? No, it's way too expensive. But meantime, if I can get one more level up, I'll be able to summon Flame Atronox without needing to get actually, I'm near apprentice level. I really want apprentice level dual cast. Not dual casting. Conjuration. Apprentice conjuration. If I get that, I'll be able to use Flame Atronox. Yeah, I definitely want apprentice conjuration, so I'm holding on to this perk for the time being.
What was that?
You saw nothing. Poof. How did I miss? Yay! Perfect.